Beautiful girls, flashy costumes, and great skating. Those are just a few of the elements that have entertained thousands of people for more than half a century at the Icecapades. Over the years, audiences have been dazzled by the show's lavish production numbers and thrilled by the skating expertise of Icecapades' ensemble skaters, as well as scores of Olympic and world champions. Most audiences never realize the enormous amount of work and preparation that goes into putting together each new show every year. An Icecapades performance may only last about 2 hours in duration, but each new show is the product of countless hours of planning, rehearsal, and sweat by both the skaters and technical crew. And for each of the nearly 70 people in this particular Icecapades company, it's a difficult and often grueling schedule that begins from the very first day of rehearsal.
We train 8 hours a day, learning the show, learning the new choreography, and then the principals are in most of the day because they're incorporated in a lot of the group numbers also. And then they work from after dinner till midnight, 1 o'clock. It's long hours. It's a lot of heavy concentration. And everyone is very intense at that point because we have to get it done in a certain amount of time, and our time is limited.
The show is on the road for 9 months out of every year, hitting a different city each week. This touring unit, Icecapades East Company, arrived in Worcester on a Monday. And bright and early the next morning, the backstage crew begins the tedious chore of moving in tons of equipment, props, and costumes for that night's opening performance.
Besides the 14 men that we travel on the tour, we have to hire approximately 45 local stagehands out of the union to assemble it, and the same number of men to disassemble it. If we do it right, it only takes 8 hours to move it in.
Once move-in is completed, the skaters and crew begin preparations for the evening show. There's plenty of activity backstage as the crew finishes the final rigging of equipment. The show's wardrobe mistress is also hard at work making last-minute repairs to the racks of expensive costumes, while her assistants make sure every item is in place for the scores of rapid-fire fast changes throughout the show. Meanwhile, the skaters arrive at least an hour before curtain time to get ready. The first order of business is to check the bulletin board for any last-minute changes to the show, as well as any other important information. Then it's on to the makeup room to primp, powder, and blush that perfect look into place.
Thanks. The kind of lighting we should have in every dressing room.
I don't know.
After makeup, the show's performance director may call the ensemble skaters together for a few last-minute corrections. Meanwhile, the show's lone musician is making his final adjustments. All of the music the skaters perform to is on tape, but it takes a talented percussionist to keep the show on the right beat, as well as supply some occasional sound effects. Finally, everything is in place. The skaters are primed and the audience ready. For the next 2 hours, it's showtime, both backstage and on the ice.
See, I've got a vibe on OG, that's V-I-V-E on OG. Your body is pumped next to me. You got that sensuality.
And no, I love what you do when you do what you do.
You got me pumped.
How do you feel when you're out on the ice and the audience is very receptive?
I feel good. I love it. That's the thing that keeps me here. I love the feeling. Mm-hmm. That really keeps everyone going. really. When you're tired and you're feeling a little low, you still have to go and perform. You do the same show for everyone, and then the applause, and it's like, oh, okay, you feel better about yourself. You feel good that you're here, and the rest of the show moves on, and you don't remember that you're tired and not feeling so well.
But do you ever get the feeling of it being routine, or does it ever get a little too tough sometimes? After 9 months on the road.
Yeah, well, you have those days, just like a regular job. You have your good days and your bad days, and the days you feel good, the days you have to work sick and injured, but you still have to do the same show. The mm-hmm. audience can't know that there's anything wrong with you. They pay the same amount as everybody, so you have to put this facade on and still look good. But you do have those days, you know, when you're not getting along with your friends, or you're... It's the same as any job, really, in that aspect. Good days, bad days.